Look at your neighbor this morning and tell the person, don't forget God.
Don't forget God.
So God told them, God knew it was likely to happen. So God said, don't forget me. So the Israelites said, we won't forget you. And then eventually, they got to the promised land. The rest is history. They began to forget about God. I'm using the word deliberately. They began to forget about God. Until God said, this forgetfulness is too much. I'm going to throw you into exile. So what God did was exactly that. Isaiah brings the grievance of God to a climax in Isaiah chapter 1, I think verse 5 or verse 3, where he said that the ox knows its owner. He said animals know their owners, and you know it. When once it is evening, hens, chickens, they start coming back home. They know the place of their owner. He said, but my people Israel, they don't consider. He said, when you ask them, how did you get this thing? He said, guy, I walk home. He said, I walk home. He said, brain deep. When you ask them how you been, and God will be there. God will be like, really, the brain. So God said, all right, so let that brain sponsor you now.
Oh, yeah,
now. Let that brain work for you. They forgot. So Moses, Isaiah told them, said, this is why God is angry with you.
Yeah.
He said, you have forgotten about him. So what did God do in that case? And so preachers will make you think that God, you know, just decided to send them into exile. Now, when you read things like God punished people in the Bible, you have to understand what is happening. After the fall of man, the elements of oppression came to the earth. Things that will cause suffering and pain became present on earth. The people of God are the only ones who are exempted. The people of God are the only ones who are exempted. Please watch. So what God is? Come, man of God, please come. So you see this? Now, I need you to come, please. Now hold something like a sword. Let's assume this is a sword, right? Yeah, hold it like a sword around this person. Now, watch. After man fell, evil came to the earth. And evil started looking to follow man. Every time God finds a man like himself, he commands protection around that man. He says, guard this man, he is mine. So evil will try to come around that person. The man does not know. But the protection of God is there for him. When that man now, if something happens, and he goes against God, God does not send evil to that man. What God does is to call his protection and say, let's go. He said he does not want us. Evil does not need to be sent. Evil is perpetually waiting. You remember Job. Satan went to God and said, why won't he worship you? You have built an edge around him. In other words, Satan had knocked on the door of Job before and there was no allowance. How did he know there was edge? So he tried going in and then there was edge. And God now said, do you see Job? He loves me. He said, why won't he love you? You remove your edge now. And you don't worry to give me command, I will go. You remove your edge then. The Israelites did not understand that their glory was in the presence of God. That what made them who they were was that God was around them.
Yeah.
This is what we call the prodigal son syndrome. The prodigal son thought that the beauty of his life was in what the father could give him. So he told the father, he said, give me what is mine. And then he left out. He didn't know that the glory of his life was not in what the father could give. It was the presence of the father himself. As soon as a man is divorced from the father, his substance will be wasted. That's exactly what happened to the Israelites. So they were there, left God, and God said, all right, then, let's remove our protection. And so you read things in the Old Testament like, I will not allow the plagues of Egypt to come upon you. In other words, I will protect you. If you have worked in a farm before, in the bush, right? You will see that the person who goes in front is the one who has to clear the path.
Yeah.
The ones who are coming, they will walk in prepared places. The person who is going in front. So God says, I will send a voice. Listen, let me tell you. Before you make the attempt to do anything, let a voice go in front of you. Let a voice go in front of you. Sit down in one place and get the voice. Say, Lord, what is the voice going in front of me? Or else you will prepare your own place.
Hey.
But if you want to enter into prepared places, it is the voice of God that prepares places for us. And that's why we don't start things, we birth things. In the kingdom of God, you don't start a thing, you birth things there. Until Zion travailed. There is a travailing where we birth things. When you try to start a thing, you struggle with it. When you birth it, it is done. The thing is settled in heaven forever, oh God. Your word is settled in heaven. The issue is earth. It is settled in heaven. There is no contention. There is nothing fighting God's word in heaven. The issue is on earth here. Because there are men, earth has been given to man. And therefore, in prayer, what we say is, let your kingdom come. Let your will, the will of God is the word of God. Your will that is settled in heaven, let it also settle on earth. That is, thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. That's what we say. So you say, Lord, I want to start this business. Give me a word. Send your word in front of me so that I will know when others are drowning that I won't drown. Your word will float me. The same water that drowned others made Noah to float. The difference there is that the word had gone. I will destroy the world, but I will preserve you. So when others were drowning and died, Noah just knew he could not. The word of preservation had gone ahead of him. Peter looked at Jesus on the water and said, Jesus, is that you? Jesus said, that's me. He said, if you are the one, if you are the one, then as you are, so am I. Tell me to come. And Jesus said, come. And you did not read the Bible. That Peter started testing the water. He started testing the water. I'm not sure if I will drown. It could just be an apparition. This may not be Jesus. I can't come and die here today. Let's test the water. Surface tension may not hold. He said, let's test the water. He did not. Immediately the word came out. He jumped out. And he began to walk on water. And he kept walking until his face moved away from Jesus to the wind. So Jesus said, if my word goes in front of you, you cannot drown.
Where we are going in this service, Pastor Mishi, where we're going is that God can organize your life. Tell me, can formulate your life, organize your life, execute your life, and supervise it. That's where we are going. That we will no longer be mere Christians. Time will not permit me again. We have to go now. But to my to talk, people use connection. Somebody say men should turn down. That's what God told me here again. If it is true that men use connection to excel, hear what God told me about this service. Only Ghost will come you connect to. Is it true that God speaks to people? Is it true that angels go on assignment for people? Is it true that men carry the presence of God? As your amen thunder, your life will experience it. Yeah!